โอเคโอเค can you see this module the first module introduction to C programming no you cannot see right share Okay, I will go through it to the introduction of to C programming, right? So in this module, I will review about the basic construct in C programming, starting from the identifiers, keywords, right? Basic data type, variables, constant, for C program operator, expressions, control statements, iterative statement functions, and pointers. I end up with a pointer. Okay. So if you could remember, right, this is the introduction to C, right? The C programming language was developed in early 1970, right, by Dennis Ritchie at Bell Laboratories. Maybe you have known about this history before, right? And what is the reason why we use C programming nowadays, right? Normally we use C programming, C, in order to write the system software, like operating system. This is, we are going to use C program, right? This is why C programming is still important nowadays. If you could remember when you go back 5 to 7 years ago, right? Chinese company, were trying to find the programmers who are specialized in operating system programming, right? And they will use these troops of programmers in order to develop their own operating system, mobile operating system, right? Because by that time, right, we used Google Android, right? But when Google didn't allow the Huawei to use their software, right? So the Huawei, right, we have to develop their own mobile operating system. So that's why C programming will be used in writing operating system, mobile operating system. And the greatest advantage of using C for programming is it can be easily used a different type of computer, right? So that's why we use C programming in order to develop the mobile application, mobile OS, operating system. Okay, and today C is widely used in Unix operating system. Okay, when we talk about C program, can you give me or can you explain about the structure or what does it mean by C program? Anyone in this room can answer my question? Today is 9/18. Who is 18? Three, four, one, eight. When we talk about C programs, right? Can you explain the structure or what is C programs? Oh, no one want to answer this question? Okay, I will give you the solution. A C program is or contains one or more function. So I will say that a C program is a set of functions. And when you want to start a C program, so you have to start from main function. The function namely main. Okay, thank you, Theo. You are a bit slow. Next question, okay, Theo. Okay, a C program contains one or more functions, right? Where a function can be defined as a group of statements that perform a well-defined task. Okay, this is a very, how can I say, simple description or this explanation of the C program. So when I think about C program, right, I will think about a set of many functions, right? So in order to write a program, right, I have to separate into many smaller parts of the program, right? Or we can say module. And then inside the module, we have to divide it. We have to divide into the function, into many functions. This is the key idea of C programs. This is why when you start to program by using C, right, you may have to think about the C program in top-down design, right? You have to think about the overall of the concept of this program and then subdivide the program into the smaller tasks. And for each smaller task, you have to write a function in order to solve that smaller problem. This is the logical thinking of the C program. Okay? And this is contrast to Java programming. Java programming is what? Java programming is not a set of functions. Actually, Java programming is a set of classes. So that's why when you write a program, right, maybe someone in this room know about Java programming, right? Think like this. Java programming is you have to separate the program. You have to define your program into a set of classes. And inside the classes, you can instantiate the objects. That's why we call object-oriented programming, right? So you have to write a class, and the class we have to separate two separate parts. The first one is a static or the variable declaration. And the next one we call methods, right? Methods is actually the same, or I would say more or less it's similar to function, but it is a function that attached to the class. So inside the class, right, you have to separate into two parts. The first one will be the variables will keep the, how can I say, the variables or the properties or the attributes of this class. And the next one will be the set of methods. So it's common that the new programmers who are familiar with C programming, and when they are trying to skip themselves into Java programmers, they will have to write a program like C style. So that is not correct, right? So in this course, what I'm trying to offer you is that I will have to know how to write a data structure and select an appropriate data structure for a problem, for a specific problem. But when you use C, you may have to use this data structure. And when you use Java, you may have to use similar data structure, or maybe not, right? But the things that you have to keep in your mind that designing in C program or designing in Java program will be different, okay? After finish this course, I hope you all will discriminate between C and Java programming, okay? And the last item, that is a main function. This one is also the most important function, right? Because it will be the first function that C program will be executed. This is also similar to the Java programming, right? Java programming, you also have the main function, but the main function will be, a main method will be special. It has to be, you have to put the model in front of the main function. Static, public static void main, right? This will be the, how can I say, the full name of the main function in C, right? If you forget to put anything, it will not be executed. It will not be executed, okay? I'm not going into detail about the Java programming because today I have to finish C programming review, right? Okay, this is a set of the function, right? You may be familiar with this. And then when you have main function and then you have this function, function one, right? When you call function one, the function one will call this, this function. And then execute all instruction inside this block. And then after finish this block, the control will be sent the control back to the main function. And the next statement after right after the function one will be executed. So it is the things that the C program does. And then if you have function one call function two and function two call function three, right? It's going to be like this. Okay, this is a sequence of the function calling another function. Okay. Okay, this is the next important things that you may have to review. That is an identifier, right? In C programming, if you want to keep or store the data, you may have to declare the set of variables or the set of identifiers, right? And identifiers will be different to the keywords, right? You cannot name the identifier the same as the keyword, right? This is a list of keywords in C programming, right? That you cannot use this keyword for your identifier or your variables. And in C programming, we have the many basic data type, right? This the basic data type. You have four basic data type in C: char, int, float, and double. Okay, character will be the size will be one, integer will be two, floating point will be four, and then double will be eight, right? And the range will be like this. Okay. You can use character in order to store the characters, right? Integer you can use for store the integer number, right? You can use float in order to store the floating point number or the small real number. And if you need to store the big floating point number, you have to use double. That is the size of 8 bytes. Okay, and if you want to have more variable or various type of the data type, you may have to use for modifier, sided or unsided, or short or long, right? To make your basic four data types to be more useful, right? So you can put this model in front of the basic data type, and then you can get more basic data type, more data type. And I've just told you that you have to declare the variables and constants in C programming, right? Okay, I'm not going to tell you about the detail of what does it mean by the variables, right? But the variables will link to the data storage location in the computer memory, right? So naming variables is important. It's very important, right? You have to name the variable according to their meaning, okay? And at the end of this session, right, about the pointers, we have to refer to the address in the memory. And in order to refer to the address of memory, you can refer by using the name, the variable name, right? C language support two basic kinds of variable, numeric variables and character variables. Okay. And this is a way of the declaring variables. And then you can initialize variable, right? If you want to initialize variable in C programming, you can use, this is the data type. This is the variable name. And then you can use equal sign, and then you assign the initialized variable or initialized values to this variable. Okay, if you want to use character, you may have to use single quote. If you want to initialize a string, right, you can use double quote, right? Okay, you can also decide the constant, right? You can just put the model const, right? concern in order to define pi will be the concern of the type floating point, and then you set to set it up to 3.14, right? This is the way that we can declare the concerns. Okay, this is the first C program, right? You may have to familiar with this program, right? Starting from the inclusion.io.h, we include this library because you want to use a print function, right? You want to give, to get the input or the, to get the input or to give the output on the screen, right? In this program, right, you are going to print out welcome to the world of C, right? This will print the message on the screen. Before we use this printf, you may have to include standard.io.h, that is, this function was declared. And in this function, you may have just only one function, that is function main, right? Only one function is function main. You can have the modifier before this function, written before this function, right? You can use int or using, you can use void, right? If you use int, you have to stop with the last expression, that is return zero. Return zero mean normal program termination. But if you return minus one, right, it will return minus one to the system. And the system will know that this is abnormal program termination. So this depends on your code, right? So here are the list of the header file, right? We also have the string.h. If you want to handle the string, you can have the standard library, right? Standard.io.h, math.h, allocate.h, and conio.h, okay? This is the list of the operators and expression in C programming. This is the list of the arithmetic operators. Okay, and we also have the relational operators. We also have the equality operators. And we also have the logical and or not operator as well, right? Okay, I hope you all can still remember about how to use these kinds of operators and expression. Okay, this is a simple program, right, for calculating the area of circle, right? You may have to start with the standard io.h because you want to get the input and print output, right? And you can use conio because you want to clear the screen. So in this program, there are two variables, radius and area, right? And then clear screen will be the function that you have to clear everything onto your screen, right? Clear and reset the screen, and then printf enter the radius of the circle, and then you can get the input by using the scanf, right? Don't forget to use ampersand, right? Ampersand sign will be used to get a value from the screen, and then put this or the store value, this or store this value into the, can I say, the floating point variable radius, okay? So this is why we use the ampersand. Okay, and this part area is a calculation for the area of the circle, and then you can print out the area of the circle. That's all. Okay, return zero, because this is integer main. So if you get the input 7, you can get the area of the circle 153.86. Okay, that's all about the simple programs in C programming. But if you want to make your program more sophisticated, you may have to use the control statements, right? There are four kinds of the control statement, like starting from if statement, if else statement, if else if statement, and then switch case statement, right? This is on the left hand side, you can see that the syntax of the C program for if statement And the right hand side, you can see the flow chart, right? You may have to be able to convert from the left hand side to right hand side or right hand side to left hand side, right? You have to do, you have to know how to do that, right? This is if statement, if else statement. If else statement, you can see that the flow chart will be true on to the left hand side and false to the right hand side. And then everyone will be connected and then merge into the statement X. So this is the way that we will write the flow chart for if else statement. Or if else if, right, if indicates that you have so many if in your statement, right? You have many conditional statements, you may have to write like this in C programs. And if you want to, maybe this one is more confusing, right? You may have to use switch case, right? In order to design or write a program for the if else if statement. So this one is more or less easier to understand, okay? And the next important statement that you need to know and you always have to do is that this is an iterative statement. When you use computer, let me say like this, right? We are, because we are lazy, right? Programming are lazy. Programmers are always lazy. That's why they want to write a program to help them in order to execute the long items of the code, right? So this is why the iterative statement will be important in C programming, right? What does it mean by iterative statement? Iterative statement will be used to repeat the execution of the sequence of the statements until the specific expression becomes false, right? If you go to or skip to this iteration, okay? In C program, C will support three types of iterative statements. As we know, right? While loop, do while loop, and for loop. What are the differences between while loop and for loop? Anyone can answer, can help me to answer this question? What is the difference of using while loop and for loop? Okay, Theo, you can try, you can turn on microphone and then answer, please.
For me, while loop is a dual loop if the condition of the loop is true. And stop this loop if the condition is false. And a for loop is a iteration of on one variable, of a start, an end, and a step, and do this loop for each iteration. It's clear? Or
Almost clear, but I think you need to answer. You missed to answer something. Anyone wants to try? When you use while loop, right? And why do you use for loop instead of using while loop?
I think it's the same.
What is the key characteristic of for loop?
A for loop is just iterates in one variable. You for a table of four is a for e in range, for example, in Python, and you iterate in the e. You start a variable, for example, to zero, and you go to the 10 with a step. Is one, and you do this loop if this while e is less than 10.
Okay, thank you. But what I thank you for answering, right? Because I want this course to be relaxed, right? And I think everyone knows about C programming already, right? And I think you can share your idea. This is the answer from Suhani. When you know the number of iterations, that's correct. When you know the number of the iterations, so you can use for loop. Okay, but in case of while loop, right, you don't have to know the number of the exact number of iterations. You can just let it loop, right? But for loop, you need to know the number of iterations. Okay. Thank you very much for your answers. Okay, if you want to while loop, to write a while loop statement, right? You can use like this, right? Statement X and then Y condition. And this loop will be repeatedly execute, right? According to this condition. If condition is still true, right? You have to do this loop. But once condition is false, right? It will go to the statement X. Okay, this is the flow chart according to the left hand side of C program while loop construct. Okay, and the next one is do while loop, right? We can also use do while loop. Do while loop mean do first and then check later. While loop, check first, do later. Okay, so this seems to be the opposite of the while loop, but actually this one will do exactly or similar to the previous one, right? Some shared. Yes, but if you want to stop your iteration, the while loop is better. The difference between while loop and for loop is while loop, you can use it to run the command until a certain condition is reached. Sakonkit. What is the difference? I cannot understand your statement. I was asking the difference, right? The difference.
Yeah, but I at first I want to try the for loop and also the while loop, but I see Suhani, she already write the for loop one that used for when you know how much the number that you want to loop.
For me, if I know the initial condition and the last condition, right, I like to use for loop. The reason why I want to use for loop because I think I can handle this loop. But actually, basic idea, right, while loop and for loop are the same, right, the basic idea, okay? But I know in advance that for loop, I will know the step size. If you want, if I want to step by one, step up by one, right, I can use X plus plus. If I want to step up by two, I can use X plus equal two, right? So this is why I know the number of the step. Even though I cannot know the exact number of the iterations, but for while loop, right? You can change normally we use the counter, right? In order to count the step or control in the while loop. But you can change the number of count by any time, by any step size or by any variables, right? But for while loop, right? You need to use exactly in the last part of the for condition, right? The for. The third part of the four, you have to, the step size should be equal. Okay, there are some answer in this chat. Make it simple. Okay, thank you very much for your answer. Right? We can discuss that in this, I may be not correct somehow, right? So you can help me to explain. Maybe you are, how can I say, you write a, and this one is for loop, Okay, in for loop, right, you have initialization part, condition part, and this one is an increment and decrement part or update. Now this is the one that I tell you, right? For loop, but you need to explicitly declare this part. So you will know in advance that what will be the incremental steps or decremental step of the for loop. Okay, so this is a tiny or simple difference between for loop and while loop. Okay, let me continue with this one, break and continue statement. Do anyone in this room know about the how can I say the difference between break and continue? If you know that, please type one into the chat room. I want to know how many people know the difference between using break and continue statement. Please press one if you know the difference and you know how to use this one, break and continue statement. 13, 14, 15, 16. We have about, there are about 18 students in this class, right? Now we have some 78 students here. Only 19, 20 students. Oh my God. Only 1/4 of the students know about how to use the break and continue student, continue statement. What, 25, 26? Please. Okay, I will give you the simple explanation about the break continue statement. First of all, I will write the for loop or the while loop first. Y I is less than or equal to 10 and I started from 0. So this program is simply print out the number, right? Number I. Okay, but we have a special if condition that is if I is equal to 5, break statement will be used, will be executed. So in this case, like if we ignore this if clause, right, you will see what? You will see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, and 10. Am I right? Right, it will be the 0 to 10 will be print out, right, from this. Am I right? Because I is less than or equal to 10. But if I put this statement, right, if I is equal to 5 and break, what does it mean by break? Break means you will skip in every single statement here. You will skip statement to the end of this block. You can see the braces, right? This is the block for while loop. You go to here, and then if you use break, break will not check for this condition. The break means break. Break means stop. No need to check for the condition, and then go to the next step, that is return 0. So this is why 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 will be printed out, and then once I is equal to 5, break will be executed and then go down out of the block, right? Block will be inside the braces and then return 0 will be executed. So 0 to 4 will be printed out. But it is opposite to the case of the continue, right? If you use if I is equal to 5 and then continue, these two programs are different only in this part, break, or continue. What does it mean by continue? Continue means if I is equal to 5 meets a condition or holds true. So continue. Continue means go out of this loop to the end of this block. But for continue, you will check for the condition. If I is still less than or equal to 10, if I still less than or equal to 10, this block will be iteratively will be repeatedly executed. Okay, so this is why the result will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 will be ignored. 5 will not be printed, and then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 will be printed out. So when I want to clarify you about this break and continue statements, break and continue statement means if you break up with your boyfriend or girlfriend, right, and then you will not be back again. This is break. But continue. If you break up with your boyfriend or girlfriend, and then you will say, okay, he or she is still good to me, he or she is nice to me, so we can go back and be back to the relationship again. This is the one that we can call continue. Okay? I'm not sure whether this is a good example or not. Why suddenly it turns so bad? Sorry for that. I didn't expect to say the sad things here. Okay. What time is it now? It is about 3. Okay. The next topic will be function. So maybe we will have a short break for 5 or 10 minutes, and then we will come back again at 3:10. Okay. I'm in pain. Okay, I will stop.